Hey everyone, this is Chris from Macombu and I'm here with Samsung's Galaxy S9 Plus, freshly launched here at MWC 2018. I'm going to do a quick hands-on to show you what you can expect. So, first off, as you can see, if you are an S8 Plus owner, the S9 Plus isn't going to look remarkably different. Samsung reckons it's slimmed down the bezels ever so slightly above and below that mighty display, but to be honest, it looks just as slender and sexy as before. That screen does pretty much fill the entire front panel. And as you can see, it just curves nicely around the phone as well to get a nice comfortable grip despite the fact that it is a mighty 6.2-incher. And around the back, you get that same glossy, smudgerific finish as well. So yeah, you might want to give your hands a bit of a clean before you handle the handset. One of the differences over last year's model is that the fingerprint sensor has thankfully moved to a more sensible location. It's right here in the center of the handset, just beneath the camera tech. So as you can see, it's not off to the side. It just falls naturally onto your finger when you pick up the handset, so it should be nice and easy to unlock the handset. It's fully water resistant as before as well, so you can give it a good old dunking when needed, and it comes in three different hues. This is of course the black model. You can also pick it up in lilac, purple or blue. That display hasn't really changed at all from last year's model. It's still a 6.2-incher, it's an 18.5:9 aspect ratio, and it's a Super AMOLED, so it's nice and punchy, and as you can see, nice and crisp as well. As you can see here, those colours really do pop off the screen. And even when you zoom right in, it stays nice and sharp. Lovely stuff. You also get stereo speakers as well. So if you're going to be watching movies, listening to music, anything like that, and you don't want to connect headphones, although thankfully there is a 3.5mm headphone jack, then you can get a bit of that on the go. It's a nice powerful sound for a smartphone, obviously. And it does support Dolby Atmos as well for a bit more of a surround sound effect. Although, to be honest, we think it just makes it a little bit louder. But don't tell Samsung we said that. It's a bit of Android Oreo on here, although of course, as usual, Samsung has added its own features and everything, so everything's changed up, the look and feel. It's got its own icons and everything, and of course, it's completely customizable, as you would expect. So you can slap on a different theme, change up the settings to get it looking just the way you want, up the grid, all that kind of stuff as well. And of course, it's a Snapdragon 845, as you might expect, backed in this case by 6 gigs of RAM. So far, it seems pretty nippy. A couple of little stams and stutters here and there, but this is early software, so we're expecting that to be completely sorted for the final version. As for the battery tech, it's a 3,500mAh cell, so hopefully it should keep you going all day, especially with the likes of the power saving modes and everything on board as well. And you can wirelessly charge it as well, thanks to that glass backing, so you don't have to bother plugging in a Type-C USB cable. So desired. As for storage, we've been told it's a choice of 64 or 128 gigs. This is the 64 gig model. As you can see, a large chunk of it is already used up by the OS and various apps that are stashed on there, but you can give it a bit of a clean when required. And it does support micro SD memory cards of up to 400 gigs in size as well, so you can expand it when needed. So on the rear of the handset, the S9 Plus does sport a dual lens camera, just like the Note 8 before it. First camera is a 12 megapixel OIS camera. It's slightly wide angle and it actually has two apertures, f1.5 for those low light conditions and f2.4 for when it's all nice and sunny in daylight. As for that second lens, it's a 12 megapixel telephoto lens, so you can choose between the two whenever you want, depending on the situation. So as you see, Samsung's camera app hasn't really changed that much, just a bit of extra functionality bolted on top. You can swap between the two different lenses with a quick tap up there. You've got Bixby Vision down here, which can now real-time translate foreign text, which is always handy. And you've got a whole bunch of little shortcuts down here, as you expect. You can fill out the screen with the whole camera app if so desired, toggle the flash and things like that. One of the new features is the new super slow motion feature that shoots it up to 960 frames per second for small snippets of your otherwise 30 frames per second HD footage. It shoots at 720p. And unlike Sony's version of it, you can actually move this little box to your subject, and then when it detects any kind of action in that section, it will automatically start filming. And of course, you now get a bit of AR emoji action. Emojis are all the rage, as well you know. And so now you can actually create your own emoji based on your own gorgeous mug, if you don't want to just put random faces into all your messages. And that's going to be compatible with the likes of WhatsApp. And that, in a nutshell, is Samsung's gorgeous new Galaxy S9 Plus. Check out our full S9 hands-on, S9 versus S9 Plus coverage, and everything else that we shot here at MWC 2018. And thanks for watching, everyone. Cheers.